conduct was harsh and oppressive, and often showed bad judgment. Would that be inconsistent with your diagnosis of it?
No. No, my colleagues and I didn't find Lieutenant Commander Queeg a perfect officer. We found an absence of mental illness.
Then you would still say the defendant was unjustified in relieving him?
From a psychiatric standpoint, completely unjustified.
My background is legal, not medical. Forgive me if I ask some elementary questions.
It's perfectly all right.
Now, Doctor, you said in previous testimony that Lieutenant Commander Queeg, like all adults, had problems which he handled well. Could you describe the problems?
I object. Lieutenant Commander Queeg is not on trial here. Lieutenant Merrick is. This question constitutes irrelevant probing of medical confidences.
I rely on the judgment of the court. Evidence regarding Lieutenant Commander Queeg's mental makeup is of the utmost importance to my case.
Question is mature, objection overruled. The doctor may answer within the limits of medical discretion. The reporter will repeat the question.
You said Lieutenant Commander Queeg, like all adults, had problems which he handled well. Could you describe the problems?
The overall problem is one of inferiority, arising from an unfavorable childhood and aggravated by some adult experiences.
What were those adult experiences?
He'd undergone a lot of strain. Long, arduous combat duty. I think that's about all I can say.
Now, sir, would he be inclined to admit mistakes?
None of us are.
Would he be a perfectionist, sir?
Yes.
Inclined to hound subordinates about small details?
Yes.
Would he be inclined to think that people were hostile to him?
Yes, that's part of the picture, yes.
Criticized, would he feel that he was being unjustly persecuted?
As I say, it's all one pattern stemming from one premise. He must try to be perfect.
Doctor, you have testified that the following symptoms exist in Lieutenant Commander Queeg's behavior. Rigidity of personality, feelings of persecution, unreasonable suspicion, a mania for perfection, and a neurotic certainty that he is always in the right. Doctor, isn't there one psychiatric term for this illness?
I never said there was any illness.
Thank you for the correction, sir. What would you call a personality that had all these symptoms?
A paranoid personality. But that is not a disabling illness.